I feel like it's that Parquet margarine commercial, right? There should be a crown. He's going to have a conversation on the side. We're starting the doubleheader. This is Mark Shields, David Brooks. I'm Hari Srinivasan. This is where we talk about the sport of politics and the politics of sport. And just joining us now, Mark Shields.
Mentally, you're checking in and out.
But he was posing for, he was mugging for the cameras. He knows he knows where to look. Okay. So on the sport of politics section, John Sununu, I think technically a co-chair of the Romney campaign, making a little news himself. Yesterday he says he made some comments that basically said that Colin Powell was voting for Obama because he's black. And then he said
it was admirable.
He said
it was admirable, which means John Sununu supporting Mitt Romney because he's white, and that's admirable. I mean, you know, why does the Romney campaign, there's got to be some devilish or diabolical streak in there. Why would you have John Sununu as a surrogate? Mm. I mean, he's always said, remember he said he was going to teach the president how to hopefully learn how to be an American? That was another Sununuism. Not to be confused with his son, who is a former senator from New Hampshire and a very admirable and appealing guy. But I mean, John Sununu is just a jerk.
How about that?
I'm trying to think. Calvin Trillin has a poem about him. If
really?
You knew what Sununu. I can't remember any other
Sununu
part of that.
Knew?
I sort of mystified by him as a surrogate. Because it has been serial foot and mouth disease for him, and your job as a surrogate is not to cause problems. But I'm mystified by all the surrogates for the campaigns. Democratic
Obama doesn't have any other than Clinton.
Well, he's got Stephanie Cutter, and you know, the surrogates are all too slashing, and they're not persuasive. Who are they? I guess they make people in the campaigns feel good because they send out attack dogs to say things that they feel privately.
Right.
But it doesn't do any good. I mean, I guess it makes them feel good. Yeah, really hitting them hard.
But I think a surrogate is different from a staff person.
Okay.
I mean, somebody who's on the staff, you know, is different. I mean, but a surrogate is somebody who has an independent identity,
right,
and chooses to be, your hired voice, and that's where Sununu. But I just don't understand what they think they're getting out of Sununu, unless it was, you know, to fire up the base or something of the sort.
Mm.
Yeah.
What do you guys think of all of this? What was this guy's name in the debate? Murdoch. The comments that he made about, I don't know if you're going to talk about it on the broadcast or not. I'm sorry if I stole some thunder there. But it's, do you think that this picks up enough traction where either campaign, right now the Obama campaign can get enough mileage out of it to paint Republicans as these knuckle draggers who all feel that women's rights are not part of the party plank?
Yeah, it doesn't help, that's for sure, coming on the heels of Aiken. And it should be said, even before Murdoch said this, he was running in a tight race
with Joe Donnelly in
Indiana.
Yeah.
And so, you know, if the Republicans lose some of these seats, Missouri, Indiana, the Tea Party brought some energy, I guess, but they've also cost them already two seats in the previous cycle and maybe two or three more in this cycle. So the Tea Party is really costing them some election.
All right. And in the politics of sports section, there's a couple of baseball games happening. We need you to lay out the predictions right now so that next week we can come back and prove you right or wrong. San Francisco's up 2-0 going to Detroit.
That makes predicting really hard.
Yes, that makes predicting really
hard. If
you're
up 2-0, you're 79% likely to win, I saw on the game last night.
Really?
Yeah.
79%?
That's what I saw. So 79% of the teams that have gone up 2-0 have won.
But San Francisco also pulled off a pretty amazing comeback from to get here, right?
Yeah,
but they're the ones that are up 2-0.
Right.
That's right.
They're the ones that are hot.
Right, right.
They really are.
Right.
I mean,
is San Francisco in how many games?
Well, no, I mean, I'm rooting for Detroit.
You are?
I like San Francisco. It's a great team, great story. But Detroit needs it more. The city needs it more.
Okay.
A city needs a win. And
so he's looking at it from the welfare state perspective of who needs it.
It's the American way of looking for the underdog. Rooting for the underdog. You know?
He's going to be an American, and so if you vote for San Francisco, you're un-American.
No, well, see, privately, in the privacy of my own living room, I'm rooting for Detroit for exactly the reason. On the NewsHour, I'm rooting for San Francisco because our viewer penetration in the Bay Area is massive.
Huge.
And so I'm totally...
I love the Giants and I love the 49ers.
No.
And Cal Berkeley is just super.
No,
Stanford
is
too. On Nob Hill, they want the Giants. Russian Hill to sort of in the Presidio area.
Yeah, definitely.
But it would be, I'm offended by the beards on some of the Giants, especially
By the beards?
It doesn't look like the House of David.
David Brooks is offended by the beards of the San Francisco Giants, but otherwise likes him.
I like Buster Posey, the catcher.
Yeah, we gotta like Buster Posey.
Okay.
What about Scudero? I mean, talk about a guy who's having a playoff. But what about Wilson?
Are we talking about Woodrow Wilson? What are we talking about, Wilson?
No, the relief pitcher.
The relief pitcher, yes.
I mean, did you see him in the dugout and he taps other people on the head? He's a frisky figure.
You're calling Wilson frisky?
At the end of the game, Buster Posey barely greets him.
Yeah.
I wonder
if
some people think it's Bush League to do all the stuff they do.
I don't know.
All right. Well, you're basically both going for San Francisco. We love our friends at KQED. You're going for Detroit.
I love Detroit.
Did you realize that our convention coverage on KQED was more watched than any convention coverage by any of the networks? And our folks in San Francisco are pretty big PBS fans.
Right.
So.
Was that the Republican convention, too, or just
I don't know. I don't know which one it was.
But we don't look at ratings.
No.
No. Unless they're exceptionally good.
That's right. On Michelle Obama night, we beat CBS and ABC. We were not competing with Fox.
Where?
Around the country.
Around the country.
Yeah.
Right. This country.
Yes, the U.S.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, they're going to start dumping us for better-looking pundits. If the ratings get
possible?
Too high.
Oh, sure.
Is that possible?
Sure.
All right, that's enough. The doubleheader stops right now. Mark Shields, David Brooks, please stay with us. Thanks for watching.